I know. The Incredibles 2 trailer came out like 6 days ago. This is the problem with me assigning a schedule for Wednesday. It literally came out on Thursday. It's been so long, and I can't do a realistic review, so I'm gonna cheat the system just a little bit, okay? Just stick with me, okay? Really, this video is gonna be about me reviewing the Incredibles 2 trailer that was released 6 days ago, but I can't really make a real video about that now because it was released 6 days ago. So I'm gonna be calling the video me ranking my anticipation Toy Story 4 with my anticipation for Incredibles 2. So let's get started. Just keep in mind that this video is really just me reviewing the Incredibles 2 trailer, and I'm running out of breath, so let's just get started. Right off the bat, the trailer looks amazing. I cannot wait, and I'm gonna say straight out, I want Incredibles 2 to be here now more than I want Toy Story 4 to be here now. Really, I can't be a full, fair judgment about that because I am gonna say it. I do not like the idea of Toy Story 4. I'm not gonna get too mad about that, but just like, hear me out a little bit. Sometimes a movie or a movie series is awesome and it does not deserve, does not need a sequel. In fact, adding on a sequel to it will ruin it. Sometimes a movie series is like that, sometimes a movie is like that. Toy Story ended like that. Again, I'm gonna ask you to stick with me and not jump at anything and not run down to the comment section down below and say, what are you saying? I can't wait for Toy Story 4. Toy Story is my favorite Pixar series ever. Give me a second, let me explain. This is how Toy Story ended. Okay, now this is how Incredibles ended.
Behold the Underminer! I am always beneath you, but nothing is beneath me! I hereby declare war on peace and happiness! Soon all will tremble!
One of them can have a sequel. The other cannot. People have to learn this. Directors, producers, companies that make movies have to learn this. Sometimes you gotta let a movie series go. This happened with Star Wars. It happened with Harry Potter, though Fantastic Beasts is pretty awesome, I'll grant you that. And it's happening with Star Wars again. Yes, granted, the Star Wars sequels are really awesome and I love them a lot, but the Star Wars prequels are clichéically bad. They're just horrible. They were entertaining, they were fun, they were what George Lucas wanted to make. A movie series for kids that he can make tons of action figures and make a ton of money. That was why he made the Star Wars prequels. There's no getting around that. But, okay, you know what guys, just give me a second. We're gonna get back to Pixar a little bit, but I'm going to go on a bit of a rant. Let me explain to you guys the hate that has been going on with Star Wars for a while now, and the hate for Star Wars that is going on right now. People were saying, oh, the prequels were so bad, the originals were so much better, and now people are saying, oh, the new ones are so bad, they're copies of the originals. Didn't you say that you wanted the originals back? Make up your mind. These people are hating for absolutely no reason. They have no idea what they are saying. One time they want the originals, the next time they don't want an original. The people who made the Star Wars sequels that are going on right now did an amazing job of making the plot that you guys wanted and adding new characters like Rey, Klo, Finn, Kylo Ren, Snoke, new villains, awesome new characters with the same plot line, and yet you just hate on it for no reason. That is not what I'm trying to say about Toy Story right now. That's not what I'm trying to say. Guys, what I'm trying to say about Toy Story is that sometimes a movie series ends and you got to accept that the movie series ended. Toy Story ended on a perfect note. It's a story about Andy, a kid who grew up with his toys, loved his toys, and then gave up his toys when he went to college. It should not continue, and this is something that producers have to get into their heads. Granted, the Star Wars sequels are great, the prequels are horrible, Star Wars sequels are great, Fantastic Beasts are great, but Toy Story especially ended. It ended on a beautiful note. On the other hand, Incredibles ended on a note that lends itself to a sequel. It ended on a note where supers were still illegal, where people are still trying to figure out, and it ended with a new villain that the Incredibles 2 will open. So now I'm gonna get into the review review of the trailer. This trailer answered so many questions that we needed answered. For example, and in my opinion, the most important one, when it takes place. We had no idea if it takes place like 15 years later, if it takes place like 10 years later, or if it takes place right after. And finally, we have the answer. Yes, it takes place right after, and we learned that because in the opening part of the trailer, we see the Incredibles fighting the Underminer. Something that I realized, guys, is that the action scene that is portrayed in the trailer is not the first encounter Mr. Incredible encountered with the Underminer, because I want to listen very carefully to this clip. You may have noticed that the movie begins with Mr. Incredible saying to the Underminer, "We meet again," and again being the key word, because this implies that they met previously and he failed at capturing the Underminer, which means now, since he failed again, his self-esteem is in ruins, in shambles, and this will continue to happen throughout the movie. Now, one of the focuses of the trailer is telling us the plot of the movie, which was Mrs. Incredible is hired by this incorporational guy who wants to
bring supers back into the sunlight.
It's made clear to us very early on that superheroes are still illegal, because Elastigirl says to Dash,
"Superheroes are illegal."
Also, I want to point out that this trailer is full of like hilarious jokes, which I am looking forward to seeing in their actual contest. For example, these two that I want to specify brought tears to my eyes, and I just kept on rewatching the trailer over and over again, anticipating these two jokes.
We want to fight bad guys.
I am a bad guy.
It defines who I am.
We're not saying you have. What?
Someone on TV said it.
All over Dusseldorf. Dussels are dozing. Their eyelids so heavy, they're drooping.
Closing!
Anyway, there seems to be two main focuses that the trailer brings, hinting to the plots of the movie. Again, Elastigirl is called in by this tycoon guy to help him
bring supers back into the sunlight.
Meanwhile, Mr. Incredible has to stay home and mind the kids, and this damages his self-esteem significantly because, one, he's not very good at it, and two, he wants to be out there fighting too. He doesn't want to be there sticking around with the kids, and you'll see him go through a severe depression throughout the entire movie. Both of these plot points, by the way, fit very well with the old Incredibles idea of the plot. Mr. Incredible went off to fight crime and get his self-esteem back, while Elastigirl decided that she had to stay home and mind the kids. And now the tables are reversed. It's time for Elastigirl to go out there and fight crime and Mr. Incredible to stay home. He has to do homework with Dash.
That's not the way you're supposed to do it, Dad.
And I say again, my favorite scene, the one where he's reading little baby Incredible a bedtime story.
All over Dusseldorf, Dussels are dozing. Their eyelids so heavy, they're drooping.
Closing!
I don't know what it is about that scene, but it's so funny. I don't know why. Tell me, does anybody else find that scene hilarious? Because I just find it hilarious. A few more things. Elastigirl has a new suit. I don't know why or how she got that suit. I don't know what purpose it solves, but she got a new suit. She is not running around with Mrs. Incredible on her chest. She is running around with her old suit with a new set of colors. Everything red is now black, everything black is now red, and everything white is now blue. Meanwhile, we see Mr. Incredible rummaging around the house trying to control the family and failing quite significantly at it, mainly with Jack-Jack and his newfound superpowers that are slowly starting to grow and develop.
But I can't keep giving him cookies! Nobody in a daddy.
I also want to point out that we see Violet three times, and I'll try to separate each and every one of them, but it seems like she is the most calmed of the entire family. She's not running around fighting crime. She's not rummaging around trying to manage the family. She's not urging to go out and fight crime like Dash is, because it defines who I am.
It defines who I am.
And then we see Edna Mode trying to give him parenting lessons. She is an awesome character, and they cannot overuse her. By the way, I personally don't think that they will. Personally, I can't wait for this trailer to be released. It seems like so much fun, and may even jump Incredibles to being my favorite Pixar movie franchise situation. Even in front of WALL-E, which was originally my favorite, but this trailer just seems like so much fun, and is perfect. It lends itself perfectly with the original Incredibles. Do you guys see what I was talking about in the beginning of the video about how The Incredibles was made for a sequel? Definitely more than Toy Story, which was an awesome series of movies, but it ended with a perfect note, and we cannot continue it because it ended with a perfect note, and I don't want to continue it. I definitely want Incredibles 2 much more than I want Toy Story 4, and you guys can have different opinions than me. I respect your opinions, but personally, I want Incredibles 2 more than I want Toy Story 4. Also, massive shout out to Hummingbird Animations for designing this. It is my name in the Harry Potter logo. You didn't misspell it, but I will not let the other viewers see how I appreciate this so much. Thank you so much. If any of you guys want to like design some art and send it to me by like picture or something, I will print it out the best I can. You can send it to schmaloalisha@gmail.com. That is my YouTube channel email, and I have it on notifications. So this is definitely going on my set. Thank you so much, Hummingbird Animation. There we go, on the wall. Though you guys may not be able to see it, I know what it is. You guys know what it is. It means a lot to me. Thank you so much, Hummingbird Animations, for making this. It really warms my heart to see it on the wall. I love knowing that you're out there and that you took the time to make this. It means so much to me. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for your support. And guys, thanks to all of you for watching. Remember to hit the like button on your way out. Subscribe so you don't miss any future videos. Hit those notifications so you'll get alerts whenever I post a new video. I upload every Wednesday. Share my channel if you know anybody, or share this video if you know anybody who likes Star Wars, Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, Disney, Pixar. I love getting new subscribers and meeting new people. I'll see you guys next time.